Coming up, we use context capture to go from this to this, an important step on our way to the final results. Roll the intro. Welcome back. I'm Tom Bentley of Bentley Systems. In the last video, we gave you an overview of ContextCapture's workflow, followed by a lesson in how to load photos. ContextCapture then checked the camera properties and the quality of the images. In this video, we cover aerotriangulation. Let's get started. ContextCapture, or more specifically, the ContextCapture Engine app, we'll take all of the photos submitted, analyze each, and attempt to locate unique features that appear in overlapping photographs. In essence, it is trying to triangulate that same feature found on at least three photos to determine their location to one another in 3D space. When we took the photographs, we emphasized, and maybe overemphasized, the importance of focusing in on the subject and capturing enough overlap between the photos. Well, this is why. Well-focused, overlapping pixels give ContextCapture the information it needs to figure out where you took each photograph and to reconstruct the three-dimensional object. Of course, ContextCapture doesn't just find a few features during aerotriangulation, it finds thousands. So, enough talk about aerotriangulation. Let's do it. To pick up where we left off in the last video, we resume working in the project file for the wooden gear. To show you where to find the project files, we're going to do this old style. We launch ContextCapture Master. Then, from the ContextCapture welcome screen, click on Open under the Open an Existing Project section. We navigate to our project folder created during the Photos Import video. We have the file extensions turned on, so you can see the file extension for ContextCapture projects is .ccm. Despite how complex the aerotriangulation, or AT as it is sometimes referred to, sounds, submission and execution of this process is very straightforward, sort of like ordering something from an online store. The store, in this case, is the ContextCapture Engine, a separate program you must launch before submitting your photos for aerotriangulation, and, later, for generating the final 3D reality model during the production step. Although we now have two ContextCapture applications running, as before, we only interact with the ContextCapture Master application. The Engine app is used in the background to perform calculation-intensive operations. ContextCapture Master uses a series of job submissions that triggers the engine to do its thing. You will see this shortly. Returning to the ContextCapture Master and Block 1 page, we click on the Submit Aerotriangulation button. At this point, the aerotriangulation wizard walks us through the creation of the job definition that'll shortly be submitted to the ContextCapture engine for processing. Because our model is very simple, we'll fly through these steps. We leave the default name and description and click Next. The component step is skipped. On the positioning and georeferenced page, automatic vertical is selected if it isn't already. On the settings page, we'll use the default settings. Again, there are a lot of settings listed here, but none of these are needed to be modified for this first 3D capture. Let the number crunching begin. Right now, our AT job is directing the ContextCapture engine to perform the complex aerotriangulation analysis. There's a good chance we'll hear the cooling fans of the computer get a little louder, as this part of the process is definitely CPU intensive. Fortunately, it will only take a few minutes to process this simple project. At this point, a new folder appears in our project, titled Block 1 AT, which indicates the aerotriangulation is complete and ready for viewing. First thing to look for are warnings. Because we did such a good job in the photo shoot, we are likely to have none, but we should always check. Next, we review the aerotriangulation results. We see that all 68 photos in the folder were processed with no rejections. If you're wondering how many tie points the ContextCapture engine was able to identify from the photos, How about 18,144? That's how many unique features the Context Capture engine used to position, orient, or pose the photos in 3D space. It's safe to say that our confidence is high that the final 3D model is going to be a good one. Enough with the text report. Let's see the results. Clicking on the 3D View tab displays the aerotriangulation results. Each dot represents a unique feature, or tie point as it's called in Context Capture. The yellow, brown, and other colors roughly match the color of the tie point as a visual reference to the subject we are capturing, in this case, a big yellow gear. From the tie points alone, it is easy to recognize the wooden gear subject, a sign of a good set of photos. Each photo is represented by a rectangle showing its position and orientation with respect to the subject. Using the camera size icons, you can get a better view of the photo orientation. Using the mouse, shift key, alt key, and arrow keys, you can navigate around the aero triangulation to closely study the results. Turning the mouse wheel zooms in and out. If we look closely at the positions of the photos, we can clearly see the three circuits we performed during the photo shoot. This, no doubt, ensured good coverage of the subject and great results at this stage of the process. If you look closely, you can make out the row of photos we took to specifically cover that hole through the gear, further confirmation that the method in the photo shoot video worked well for this subject. Although in this project it's pretty obvious the photos are well aligned to the subject, in other projects you may need to confirm which photo is associated to a specific pose, maybe one that looks out of place or just odd. Clicking on the photo's pose displays the photo itself and its 3D properties. The aerotriangulation processing generated the pose properties, showing the X, Y, and Z point of the photo, plus its rotation. In addition, the expanded cone over the tie point helps us roughly identify how many of those points are likely identified from this one photo. All in all, this model is looking good and is ready for the final step, generating the full resolution 3D reality model. In the next video, we complete the 3D capture process by first setting some reconstruction values and engaging the Context Capture engine to produce the final 3D reality model. If you have questions about what we just covered, please visit the Reality Modeling Forum on Bentley Communities at the link provided in the description below. Be sure to subscribe to our channel to follow along with the rest of this video series. Thanks, and we'll see you next time.